very warm welcome to all my lovely students. Hope you all are good. This is your English teacher, Mrs. Junaki Biswas, and I am once again back with your online classes. Students, today in this video, you will learn a grammar topic, that is conjunction. Conjunction, as the word suggests, it means joining words or linking words. And students, conjunction is one of the most important topic of grammar. It plays a very important part in the parts of speech. Now, you have learned conjunction in the previous classes, but not in detail. You must have learned the conjunctions of some of the very known conjunctions you must have learned in the previous classes, like use of and, but, because, or. Today, I will explain those once again. Along with that, I will be explaining some more conjunctions. But before I go to that topic in detail, now let me ask you something, students. I have two sheets in my hand. These are A4 size sheets. Now, if I tell you to make these sheets single one or to join these sheets, how will you join these sheets? Like this, isn't it? Now, what will you use to join, students? Of course, either you will use a glue stick or a Fevicol to join it. So, what we are doing? We are joining two sheets with the help of, we are joining two sheets and we are making it one with the help of Fevicol. So, what we are doing, students? We are joining. So, from this only you can get the idea, students, that we will be learning something today about joining. Yes. So, you will learn today how to join sentences with words, and those words are called as conjunctions. So, to know conjunctions in detail, have a look at the board now. You should know the definition of the conjunctions. So, have a look at the board, students. Lesson 11, conjunctions, as I told you, they are also called as joining words or connecting words, linking words. Now, the definition is must. Conjunctions are words used to join other words, phrases, or sentences. I'm repeating once again. Conjunctions are special words which are used to join other words. Now, these words can be two nouns, two adjectives, two pronouns, or maybe one noun and one pronoun. So, conjunctions are used to join words, phrases, or sentences. Now, let us take one small example. Two sentences are here. My brother cooked rice, sentence number one. Sentence number two, my brother cooked curry. So, there are two things done by my brother. So, instead of writing two different sentences, students, we can make it as one sentence also. So, how will we make it single sentence? We can make it a single sentence by using conjunction. And here, we have used the conjunction and. And while we are using the conjunction and, students, we will avoid repeating of words. Like, my brother cooked rice. We have written the same sentence. My brother cooked rice, and then we have added and. My brother cooked rice and curry. So, what we have done? We have not repeated my brother cooked in the second sentence. So, now, students, have a close look at the board once again. First, it is the definition of conjunction. That is, conjunctions are words used to join words, phrases, or sentences. And the example, two sentences I have written, both have the similar idea. My brother cooked rice, my brother cooked curry, and I have joined it with my brother cooked rice and curry. So, the conjunction what we have used here is and, to join the two sentences. Now, students, let us study some of the conjunctions in detail. Now, you are in class 4, students, so you have some idea regarding conjunctions, or some of the conjunctions you must have studied. So, some common conjunctions which we will study today are and, but, because, and or. And I hope that you have already studied the use of and, but, and because in the previous classes. If not, I will be teaching them once again today in detail. So, now the first conjunction which I will teach you is and. where do we place and? And the examples. So have a look at the board. The first conjunction which you will study today is and. Now where do we use and? Or what and shows? So and shows addition of two things. That means joining of two things. When we are joining two things, we always use the conjunction and. So and shows addition of two things. And in the second one, it joins words and conjunctions with a similar idea. Now, what is the meaning of similar idea? That means, similar means same ideas. So when both the sentences are of same idea, there is no contradictions, then we use the conjunction and. So and shows addition of two things. And the next point is joining of two sentences with similar ideas. Now let us see the examples. I have taken the first example as the first sentence, Meena danced. Second sentence, Saloni danced. Now these are two separate sentences, but the idea is same. Both of them are dancing. So we will join this with the help of and. So it is Meena and Saloni danced. Meena and Saloni danced. And here students, what we are joining? We are joining two proper nouns. Meena and Saloni are the names of two different persons. And two different persons, so they are proper nouns. So in the first sentence, what we are doing? We are joining two proper nouns. Now let us see the second example. You are polite. You are honest. Again, two different sentences, but both are having the similar idea. Means we are telling the quality of someone. So we are writing it as you are polite and honest. So again, we have joined it with and. And here students, what we are doing? We are joining two adjectives. Polite and honest are two adjectives. We are joining them. Now see the third one. Third is Ram is going. I am going. Again, two different sentences, but the idea is same. Both of them are going. So we have joined Ram and I are going. Ram and I are going. And in the third example, what we are doing, students? We are joining with a noun and a pronoun. Ram is noun and I is pronoun. So we are joining a noun and a pronoun in the third example. So once again, students, have a look at the board very closely and listen to the points which I am repeating once again. The first conjunction which we will study is and. And shows addition, that means joining of two things. It even joins words and sentences with similar, that is same idea. The first example which I have taken, Meena danced and Saloni danced. And I joined it as Meena and Saloni danced. And here, Meena and Saloni, two proper nouns are joined. In the second one, you are polite, you are honest. I have again similar idea, joined it with and. You are polite and honest. And in this sentence, students, we have joined two adjectives. And in the third one, Ram is going, I am going. We have joined it with and. Ram and I are going. Ram and I are going. And what we have joined here, students? We have joined a noun and a pronoun here. Now, the next conjunctions which you will be studying is the use of but and because. Where we use but and where we use because. There are again separate rules for both of them. So have a look at the board now, students. First of all, use of but. Where do we use but? We use but to show contrast, means something different, opposite, or opposite ideas. Now remember, students, while I was explaining you and, I said that we use and to join the sentences with similar ideas. But we use but to join the sentences which have opposite ideas, that is different, and so it is also called as contrast. Now let us see the example. I like apples, I don't like mangoes. So these are two different sentences, that I like apple but I don't like mango. Now how can we join? These are two different things, that is opposite ideas. So here we will use but. I like apples, but I don't like mangoes. We We can take some other example as I like Hindi, I do not like maths. Again, two separate things. One is liking, one is dislike. So we will there also we will write like I like Hindi, but I do not like maths. So here, but we show or join the sentences with opposite ideas. Now, because we always use in those sentences which gives a reason, like why I am doing this work. So question as well as the answer both will be there. I went to the market. I wanted to buy some fruits. So why did you go to the market? Because you wanted to buy some fruits. So question as well as answer both are there. So in such cases where question and answer is there, or you can say in other words as reason is there, we will use the conjunction because. So I've joined it with because. I went to the market because I wanted to buy some fruits. Now students, again have a close view of what I have written here. The second conjunction is but. It shows contrast or opposite ideas. The example which I have taken, I like apples, I don't like mangoes. Two different sentences. Answer to it is when we are using but. I like apples, but I don't like mangoes. The third conjunction is because. Because gives us a reason. As I told you, question with the answer. I went to the market is sentence number one. Sentence number two is I wanted to buy some fruits. Now, question and answer both are there. So, I have to use because here. So, the answer is I went to the market because I wanted to buy some fruits. The last conjunction which you will study today in this video is or. Where do we use the conjunction or? We generally use the conjunction or to indicate or show choice. Now, have a look at the board, students. Conjunctions, the last conjunction which we will study for today is or. And it indicates choice. That means two choices will be given to you. And in those type of sentences, we will always use or. Now, see the first example here. Would you like tea? Number two, would you like coffee? So, again, it is a choice. Do you like tea or coffee? So, we have joined it. And what we have joined? We have joined it with a conjunction or. Would you like tea or coffee? So, we have not repeated this would you like again in the second sentence. So, what we have done is would you like tea or coffee? And then we will end it with a question mark. So, to indicate choice, we use or. So, have a look once again now. Or, it indicates choice. Two sentences we have taken. Would you like tea? Would you like coffee? Now, if we are asked to join these two sentences, because it is a choice, we will use or. And the answer is, would you like tea or coffee? So, this would you like, we will not repeat in the second sentence. So, students, in this video, I explained you four conjunctions. Very important four conjunctions, that is and, but, because and or. Hope students, the things are clear to you. In the coming videos, I will be doing some more other conjunctions. So till then students, goodbye and take care.